Welcome back. If you're just joining us, our breaking news tonight only here on 360. Sources telling us that not one single FBI agent has made it to Benghazi, to the scene where four Americans were killed on 9/11. Also, those same sources telling our friend Townsend that FBI requests through the State Department to get to Libyans to secure the scenes have gone unfulfilled. Additionally, according to sources, suspects whom the Libyans have in custody have not been made available for direct FBI questioning. And from the get-go, our sources say this looked like a terror attack. Back with us, national security contributor friend Townsend, who broke this remarkable story just moments ago. Also on the phone, Georgia Republican Senator Johnny Isaacson and Congressman Michael Turner, Republican from Ohio. So, Senator Isaacson, first of all, your reaction to this information.
Well, this entire thing mystifies me. We have an administration apparently without a policy or looking the other way, referring to the tragic death of an ambassador as a bump in the road. I do not understand the continuance of the president to look the other way and not admit to the fact that this was obviously a terrorist attack. And I cannot believe that the FBI is not on the ground yet and there's not enough cooperation to get them there.
Congressman Turner, if the FBI investigators have yet to set foot in Benghazi, how is their investigation supposed to be credible?
No, obviously it can't be. And this goes right to the failure of this administration's policies in Libya. You know, we have to put this in context of just a year ago, the president spent nearly $1 billion U.S. dollars with warships right off the coast of Libya attacking the Muammar Gaddafi regime for the purposes of transitioning Libya without a stated policy or defined policy of who we were supporting, what we hoped to gain, the geopolitical view of those who might come to power. And now the president continues to operate in an area where he has no articulated policy, and now four Americans are dead, our ambassador is dead, and the president still has yet to be able to describe what has occurred and really what is the president's policy. Why is it that the president is operating a year after having attacked Libya without a policy?
Well, Congressman, I mean, to be fair, though, and supporters of the president and the policy will point out, time was of the essence, given Muammar Gaddafi's stated intention to basically invade Benghazi, go house to house and pull people out and kill them, I think, like rats or words to those effect. But Senator, you and Senator Jim DeMint have written to Secretary Clinton requesting any diplomatic cables that might have come from Ambassador Chris Stevens. What motivated you to make such a request? What are you hoping to learn, Senator, from those cables?
Well, first of all, it was myself and Senator Corker
really don't
from
think
Tennessee.
Anderson.
Sorry, Senator, the question was to you since you requested the cables.
Right. And, well, first of all, CNN uncovered the diary of Craig Stevens at the scene. CNN reported that the diary said that Craig Stevens wrote that he thought he was in danger and was out on Al-Qaeda's hit list. I can't believe a U.S. ambassador who would write in a diary would not have sent cables to inform the State Department of his danger, and I think that is probably what happened. I think the State Department should be forthright. We should know what communications they had leading up to September 11th. And if, in fact, the United States State Department in this country knew in advance of the attack that its ambassador felt like it was in danger of his death or imminent demise from Al-Qaeda, and we didn't take any action to secure him, that sends an appalling message to ambassadors around the world representing the United States of America.
And Senator, if you don't get these cables, I mean, is there anything really you can do? You requested them. Can the committee subpoena the items?
Well, the committee can move forward, and we've talked with members of the committee and some of the leadership of the committee. In fact, if the administration claims executive privilege or looks the other way and denies it, Senator Corker and I will continue to pursue it because we think the American people, the Congress of the United States, and certainly the family of Craig Stevens deserve an answer, and they deserve it now.
Congressman, I mean, you've been in briefings about this. What do you make of kind of the narrative that we've heard from administration officials about, well, it was linked to this video and it's still being investigated and we're not sure, and now this reporting tonight and today that at least within the intelligence community in the first 24 hours, they felt confident this was a terror attack?
Well, and Anderson, I don't think we can give this administration the benefit of the doubt. I think the fact that they are trying to blame it on non-terrorist attack comes right to the heart of the fact that this is a president that took NATO and the United States into an offensive action into Libya without a clear stated policy, spent nearly $1 billion, continues to have not a clear stated policy of what our relationship is to those who are in charge, the geopolitical evolution that's occurring there, and at the same time is not providing clearly the type of security security that's necessary in the environment that we're in. You know, I don't think there's anybody who in Congress or the Senate can articulate what this president's policy is post-Qaddafi in Libya. He certainly didn't articulate it when he began the military action against them, and he certainly isn't now, leaving, I think, Americans at risk.
Congressman Turner, I appreciate your time. Senator Isaacson as well.